Tag TV brings you daily news bulletin from India. Breaking news and views from India.
Good evening. Welcome to South Asia Newsline. I'm Shreya Savijay. Here are the top stories we are tracking for you on Tuesday, the 5th of January. India's Uttar Pradesh state rolls out dry run for COVID-19 vaccination. Residents in Pakistan-administered Kashmir angry over fuel price hike. And Nepal's ruling party purging disgruntled unruly forces, says Interior Minister Thapa. And now for all the details. India's northern state of Uttar Pradesh on Tuesday started a dry run exercise in all its 75 districts for vaccination against the coronavirus. According to the country's health ministry data, Uttar Pradesh is among the most COVID-19 affected states in India, with over 588,880 confirmed cases and more than 8,410 deaths reported so far. India's northern state of Uttar Pradesh on Tuesday rolled out a dry run in all its 75 districts for vaccination against the coronavirus. Authorities deployed home guards, policemen and workers affiliated with Social Welfare Department in addition to health workers for the dry run. Uttar Pradesh Chief Minister Yogi Adityanath also visited Dr. Ram Manohar Lohia Institute of Medical Sciences in to oversee the exercise.
हम लोग यहाँ पे पेशेंट को जिनको वैक्सीन लग जा रही है उनको आधे घंटे तक यहाँ पे वेट कराएंगे, देखेंगे कि उनमें कोई रिएक्शन तो नहीं हो रहा है. अगर हो रहा है तो हमारे पास सारे इमरजेंसी किट अवेलेबल है, तो उस अकॉर्डिंग मैनेजमेंट करेंगे जैसे सिम्टम्स होंगे पेशेंट के.
आज का ड्राई रन पूरे प्रदेश में हो रहा है, सभी 75 जिलों में, और हर जिले में 6-6 केंद्र पर ड्राई रन किया जा रहा है, 3 शहरी क्षेत्र में और 3 ग्रामीण क्षेत्र में. इसलिए पूर्वाभ्यास में यह देखा जा रहा है कि जब हम वास्तविक वैक्सीनेशन का कार्य प्रारंभ करेंगे तो हमारे सामने क्या क्या चैलेंजेस आएंगे, उन सभी चीज़ों को आज पूर्वाभ्यास के माध्यम से देख करके और जो भी उसमें गैप्स पाए जाएंगे उन सब को एड्रेस कर लिया जाएगा.
According to the Federal Health Ministry, Uttar Pradesh is among the most COVID-19 affected states in India, with 588,882 confirmed cases with 8,413 deaths. Last week, the ministry conducted a similar exercise across the country. This comes at a time when Drugs Controller General of India, or DCGI, over the past weekend approved 2 COVID-19 vaccines, the AstraZeneca, known as Covishield, manufactured by the Serum Institute of India, and the indigenously developed Covaxin of Bharat Biotech for restricted emergency use. The emergence of bird flu has caused an alarm in India's central Madhya Pradesh state, where the presence of the virus has been confirmed in dead crows. The presence of the virus has also been confirmed in dead birds in several other Indian states, including Kerala and Himachal Pradesh.
Authorities in India's Madhya Pradesh have sounded a high alert after dead crows with symptoms of bird flu were found in Mandsaur, Indore and other districts of the central state. The samples of the birds were sent to laboratory for testing, after which the discovery of the disease in the birds was made. Around 100 crows alone died in Mandsaur between December 23 and January 3, reports suggest. Avian influenza, commonly called bird flu, is an infectious viral disease of birds, mainly found in ducks and geese. Wild birds can carry the virus without showing symptoms of it and transmit it to poultry through their feathers or feces.
ये जो कबूतर पाया जाने वाला है वो H5N8 है. इसलिए उतना घातक नहीं है, लेकिन फिर भी जो हमारे विभागों ने पूरा अलर्ट कर दिया गया है कि वो सुरक्षा में जितने कदम उठाएं देखें कहीं भी कबूतर की मोर्टिलिटी तत्काल टेस्ट करें और उस क्षेत्र में जितने भी पोल्ट्री फार्म हैं या पोल्ट्री पालने वाले लोग हैं या विक्रेता हैं उनमें नज़र रखें.
Meanwhile, around 53 carcasses of birds, including herons and ducks, were also found in Junagadh in India's western Gujarat state. However, the reason for their death was yet to be ascertained till the last reports came in. Earlier this week, carcasses of around 1,800 migratory birds, including common teal and bar-headed goose, were also found in Dharamshala in India's northern Himachal Pradesh state and tested positive for bird flu.
Scores of protesters staged a demonstration outside the Canadian embassy in Paris on Monday, demanding a thorough investigation into the mysterious death of Baloch activist Karima Baloch in Canada late last month. The protesters alleged role of Pakistani spy agencies into her death, as she frequently got threats from exposing atrocities by the Pakistani state and the army in Balochistan.
Several protesters, including Baloch, Pashtun and Hazara activists, on Monday staged a demonstration outside a Canadian embassy in Paris, demanding thorough investigation into the mysterious death of Baloch activist Karima Baloch in Canada late last month. The protesters rejected Canada's Toronto police findings of no foul play into Karima's death, whose dead body was found drowning in Lake Ontario on December 22nd, 2 days after she went missing. The protesters alleged role of Pakistani spy agencies and termed the 37-year-old activist dead as targeted killing, as she frequently got death threats for exposing atrocities by the Pakistani state and the army in Balochistan at international forums, including the UN.
We demand from your government, from your police authorities, from the Canadian authorities that they should investigate the mysterious death of Karima Baloch through scientific methods. They should consider all those risk concerns which she was facing on her life security.
The protesters also highlighted the rising incidence of enforced disappearances and extrajudicial killings in Balochistan and blamed Pakistani establishment of eliminating dissenting voices in the region.
Moving on, locals in Pakistan-administered Kashmir have expressed anger and dismay over a recent hike in fuel prices amid unprecedented inflation. The residents in the illegally occupied region accused Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan of being apathetic towards their plight, while blaming his inefficient policies for the ongoing economic crisis.
People in the illegally occupied region of Pakistan-administered Kashmir are facing immense difficulties due to the consistent increase in fuel prices by Islamabad amid inching inflation. With the beginning of the new year, Oil and Gas Regulatory Authority has increased the prices of petrol by ₹2.31 per litre. Petrol is now available for ₹106 per litre, while diesel for ₹110.24 per litre. Locals express the soaring prices of most commodities have already left them in despair, and soon a direct impact of increase in fuel prices will be now witnessed on prices of essential food items as they are transported via road. Locals accused Pakistani Prime Minister Imran Khan of being apathetic towards their plight, blaming that the economic losses being faced by Pakistan due to policy paralysis are being compensated from the regions under its illegal control.
In news from Afghanistan, Afghanistan's President Ashraf Ghani has said there will be no compromise on the security and the defense forces in the peace negotiations, and that the troops have given the highest sacrifice in the last 6 years. The remarks come as the negotiating team of the Afghan government and the Taliban are about to begin the second round of peace talks in Doha that are expected to focus on ceasefire and a reduction in violence in Afghanistan.
Afghan President Ashraf Ghani has reiterated that there will be no compromise on security and the defense forces in the peace negotiations with Taliban and that the troops have given the highest sacrifice in the last 6 years. Ghani made the remarks while addressing security forces at an event at the Ministry of Defense earlier this week. Meanwhile, U.S. Special Envoy Zalmay Khalilzad, while expressing hope ahead of Doha talks, has said he's expecting the warring parties will make tangible progress in the next round of Afghanistan peace negotiations. Taking to Twitter, the envoy said both sides must demonstrate they are acting in the best interest of Afghan people by making real compromises and negotiating an agreement on a political settlement as soon as possible and an immediate significant reduction in violence and ceasefire. This comes as the negotiating team of the Afghan government and the Taliban are about to begin the second round of peace talks in Doha that are expected to focus on ceasefire and a reduction in violence in Afghanistan.
In news from Nepal, Nepal's Interior Minister Ram Bahadur Thapa has said that senior leaders are working to purge some unruly and disgruntled forces within the ruling Nepal Communist Party. The remark comes at a time when Nepal's parliament has been dissolved. Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli argues the move is to seek a fresh mandate as the government was held hostage to infighting in his ruling Nepal Communist Party.
Nepal's Home Minister and the Secretariat Member of the ruling Nepal Communist Party, or NCP, Ram Bahadur Thapa, has said that senior leaders are working to purge some unruly and disgruntled forces within his party. Addressing a meet organized by Prime Minister K.P. Sharma Oli's Nepal Communist Party faction, Thapa said purification would help strengthen the party. This comes as the lower house of Nepal's parliament has been dissolved on the recommendation of PM Oli. Oli says he took the step as co-chair Pushpa Kamal Dahal and his supporters within the NCP had reached the point of no return and he faced possible expulsion both as party chief and as prime minister. The move has ended the unity forced among the left forces that had led to the creation of the single Grand Nepal Communist Party 3 years ago. PM Oli has now declared the next election will be held on April 30 and May 10 in Nepal with him leading a caretaker government.
Moving on to news from Bangladesh. The Bangladesh government has granted approval for the emergency use of the Oxford University AstraZeneca coronavirus vaccine. The approval to import the vaccine was granted by the Directorate General of Drug Administration of Bangladesh late on Monday to Beximco Pharmaceuticals, which has signed an agreement with the Serum Institute of India for importing 30 million shots of the vaccine for Bangladesh. This comes as Bangladeshi Foreign Minister Dr. A.K. Abdul Momen told media persons on Monday that the vaccine from Indian manufacturers was expected to arrive in Bangladesh by the end of this month. Bangladesh has reported over 516,000 confirmed cases and more than 7,625 deaths so far. Srinagar, the summer capital of India's Jammu and Kashmir, has been covered with a blanket of snow as most areas of the valley received moderate snowfall over the past weekend. Tourists on Tuesday were seen enjoying the weather as well as the beauty of the iconic Dal Lake covered with snow. Have a look.
Snowfall in India's Jammu and Kashmir on Tuesday brought cheers to the tourists who trickled in from different parts of the country. Summer capital Srinagar was covered in white with snow adding to the beauty of the iconic Dal Lake, much to the delight of the tourists who were seen playing in the snow.
Really, it's amazing. Matlab ek word mein main express nahi kar sakti hu, but it's lifetime mera experience. बहुत अच्छा लग रहा है
हाँ बहुत सारे टूरिस्ट लोग भी आए हैं यहाँ पर बर्फबारी देखने के लिए श्रीनगर में वो बहुत खुश है यहाँ सब होटल बुक है
कश्मीर वैली इज करेंटली अंडर द ग्रिप ऑफ जिल्ला कलान द 40 डे हार्शेस्ट विंटर पीरियड व्हेन अ कोल्ड वेव ग्रिप्स द रीजन एंड द टेम्परेचर ड्रॉप्स कंसिडरेबली लीडिंग टू द फ्रीजिंग ऑफ वाटर बॉडीज Snowfall in the valley has a direct impact on temperatures in lower northern states of New Delhi, Punjab, Haryana, and Uttar Pradesh.
Well, that's all we have for you from South Asia this evening. Now, viewers can watch the show on southasianewsline.com. You can also visit us on facebook.com/sasianewsline and follow us on Twitter @sasianewsline. That's all in tonight's edition. We'll see you same time tomorrow. Good night.
Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button. Subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.